Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, Gemini. This is a reading for you, weekly reading. Let's find out, Gemini. You have a person in mind. Let's find out what's going on and their feelings towards you. All right. I'm using my very own tarot deck, the NomadSoulWarrior Tarot. If you want to get a copy of this deck, check out my Etsy shop. The link is in the description box below. All right, Gemini, let's get started. Gemini, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and Jupiter. What's going on? Okay. Death card is your first card. So let's find out what's being cooked here. Okay, bookends, we have Death and the Ten of Swords. You're on guard right now. Yeah, you're on guard right now. Feel like the situation may probably seem to have ended between you and the person you have in mind. Seems, yeah, to have ended. And this person can be a fire sign, Libra, Taurus, Scorpio. Could also be Aquarius Moon. I feel like they have this person is has a very interesting characteristic, yeah. They are engaging, yeah. This is someone who is very attractive, yeah, for most people, yeah. Not just for one or two. So you have a very attractive person right here, yeah. And somebody who is charming, who gets what they want when they pursue it, yeah. And somebody who probably is being looked up in their work environment, yeah, or even in their family. Yeah, so this person is not a low level type of personality, which is really good. Yeah, really good. But no matter how they look in the outside, yeah, deep inside, I feel like this person is pretty sad right now. Yeah, feeling as though they are alone, likely because things may have ended between the two of you. Yeah, there's been an ending, and it may have shocked this person out. It may have changed their usual approach to life, you know. But I do sense that someone here is trying to avoid drama, yeah, not getting into the nitty-gritty of things, but rather facing the situation with clear head, with logical thinking. And I feel that that is this person's approach for you or towards you. Gemini, you stop communicating with this person. You stop engaging. And I feel like they can see too, because when you stop, they can see that you know that that is the best way for you, and that's why you're doing so. But they also know that you are highly disappointed, highly hurt, or that you're just not happy with the current situation, with the breakup, or with them pulling away. They know that. Yeah, they know that. This person knows that. Let's get you more cards here, because it seems like there was an ending, but there are still some energy moving around. Yeah, okay, no wonder. Okay, at the bottom of the deck we have the Page of Cups. So the more you're not talking to this person, yeah, I feel like They are realizing, yeah, that they are interested, yeah. I don't know, the distance is making this person realize what matters most to them, yeah. And I feel like what matters most to this person is the connection, yeah, the relationship or the connection they had with you and the connection they have with you. If there was an argument in the past where, you know, an exchange of words that could have been hurtful, this person is processing it, and they know that they have said something that could be really hurtful for you, and that could be a reason why you stormed out or you ended things. Yeah, but somebody here ended the situation, so that could be one reason. They know that now. Yeah, so they are processing it. They are internalizing whatever has been said, whatever has been done. And I feel like they still want to be connected with you. They still want this relationship. Yeah. Or this connection with you. Somehow this person is suspecting that you are probably engaging with other people right now, or that the reason why you're not very involved with them anymore or not interested with them anymore is because you have someone new. Yeah, it's because you have someone new. For some of you, if you are showing signs, yeah, that you are open to communicate, or if you have probably liked their social media, you know, those little tiny signs, then hugely this person would think, yeah, that, oh wow, Gemini is noticing me again, or that Gemini is wanting to reconnect. So that could possibly, for them, that could be a sign that you are wanting to re-engage again. So you're giving them signal to re-engage again. Yeah, that is if you are showing like tiny little bits of interest, yeah, towards them. But definitely, if we're talking about whether this person wants commitment, yes, yeah, they want that. It's just that in terms of the connection with you and where this situation is at right now, there seem to be no direct path to be in that stable long-term relationship. It seems like the interest, the attraction is there for two people, you and them. And the desire for, you know, being with each other long term is also there. It's just that, will the relationship thrive in the long term? And I think that is the big question here. Yeah, I feel like this person is wanting more. Yeah, perhaps they were the ones who wanted more from you, and you're not giving in. Or if they want commitment towards you, you may have told them that, yeah, I like you, I love you, but I'm just not ready for commitment. It's pretty opposite to the Taurus reading that I did just now, like the opposite side. So like I said, this is a general reading. You can pick your side and see whichever is resonating more for you. Yeah, so this would be either for a Gemini or a cross watcher. For now, I feel like this ending would still feel like it's an, or this situation would feel like it has ended. Yeah, it would feel like it has ended, because for the most part, I feel like no one is reaching out to anyone, at least at this moment. Let me grab more cards just to give us more perspective here. Yeah, so far for now, I feel like the desire to fix things is there. Yeah, but taking action, as of this moment, nobody is taking that step, because it could create drama, or it could, you know, just add into the burdens of your daily life right now. So that is applicable actually for both of you. You are hesitating to possibly reach out to them just because it could, you know, you're digging back some old drama in the past, opening the Pandora's box. Or this could be that person, yeah, not taking in because as of the, not reaching out because as of the moment, they feel like there is still that conflict, unresolved conflict, and they don't know how to face it or how to address it. But the desire to fix the situation is there, yeah. But the next step should be, what is the best step to do? Yeah, to fix that situation. And I feel like this person is processing it. Yeah, and being away from the situation for a while, or having distance from each other could actually give some more clarity. Yeah, that taking time off. Yeah. It's just like if you're working for the whole year and, you know, you take a break for about 2 weeks or so, the next time you come to work, it feels like, oh, it's a brand new day, you know, that sort of feeling. So this person is doing so. Because after that, when they come back, they're bringing in the softer side of things. They're bringing in the new opportunity. This could be an opportunity for both of you to talk, to talk about the relationship and what is really in here that both of you are interested in. And I feel like that is where you will start talking. Yeah, that is what you will start to talk about. You know, you will reconnect and... But it's more like making that decision, yeah? Where do we go from here? And it's rather more concrete, so you cannot be indecisive at this moment when this person comes back, yeah? And nevertheless, we still have the sun. So there is a happy outcome here, by the way. It's not just shown for this week, but you can follow through with my future readings to see if those readings will resonate with you. Because there is a future happiness. Be happy. It's more like the future looks bright for both of you. At least for this situation. Because somebody is bringing in this. There is a new opportunity here. This, yeah. For some, this could be an opportunity of success, money related, promotion, new house. Yeah. As you notice, I'm mentioning those tangible things which are of value. Well, you can have the car, but a car is you know, it's a necessity for some people, but for the most part it depreciates right after you own it, right? So this is not reflective of a car, at least for my reading, but more like, you know, those things that would appreciate. So it could be relationship, love, or even you investing in yourself. Right? Because sooner or later, you will get the high rewards of it. I'm going to leave it at that and let me know if this resonates in the comment section below. And don't forget to hit like and subscribe.